Sajid caught up with the company's MD Vinod Dasari at the Chennai Defence Expo. Here are what he had to say.
I think it is a very exciting journey ahead. About 4 years ago, we restructured our defence business to have a very clear focus on not just selling logistics vehicles. We are one of the world's largest provider of logistics vehicles to the armed forces, primarily to the Indian armed forces. And we said, why should we only move people? Why not everything else that the army requires to move? So rather than compete in 2% of the capital expense of the Ministry of Defense, we now compete in about 22% of it. So giving us a much larger canvas to play on. So everything that is required to move, whether it's a bulletproof personal carrier like this, yeah, or carrying missiles or carrying guns or carrying radar. So what used to be 4x4 has now gone to 6x6, 8x8, 10x10, 12x12. And defense takes a long period. But once it's there, it stays for a very long period of time. Many, many places we are very proud that where Indian Army used to have to import, we've been able to substitute with local. So it is one of our fast-growing businesses. We have now almost 800 crores this year. We will be one of the largest private players for the Indian Armed Forces. And we have won several tenders. I think just in the last 1 year, we have won 12 out of 15 tenders. And these tenders are for developmental orders. And as they start getting converted into real things, you will see just this much will give us a cumulative revenue of about 5,000 crores in the next 5 years or so.
Orders in the last 1 year gave you order book of nearly 5,000 crores over the next 10 years. Next 5 years. Is that an ongoing thing? Because you're going to be participating in now a wider variety of vehicles here. So what kind of opportunities that throw in? Are you being able to capture the entire 22%, or you're just now in a process of, you know, creating prototypes and then showcasing it?
So these are development orders. Okay, if I add up all the projects that we are working on and we get all of these orders, then we are easily more than 50,000 crores. But it's not like I do a project and immediately it works. So first step is that there is an RFI, then there is an RFP, then you make a vehicle, then there is a development order, then there is trials and so on, and then it gets into a bigger order. This is a long gestation business, but it is not cyclical. Once you're in for a very long period of time. Second thing, it gives you significant opportunity to export. Like this vehicle that you're talking about behind us, there's already a very good demand for export outside to many countries nearby as well as far away. So we're looking to build this business based on our core competency of automotive technology and not get into things like submarines and missiles and guns and all of that. We will not get into that. We'll stick to our business here.